Allies and political rivals find common ground as they pay tribute to former President Noynoy Aquino. Former Senator Mar Roxas, Aquino's running mate in the 2010 elections, who also served as his interior secretary, thanked the late chief executive for his contribution to the country. He said Aquino left things so much better than how he found them. Also paying tribute to the former president, his predecessor, Gloria Macapagal-Arroyo. She released a statement expressing sympathy to her student turned political rival. It was under Aquino's term that Arroyo was detained for nearly 4 years due to corruption charges.
The Catholic bishops in the Philippines expressed their sorrow over the death of former President Aquino. In a statement, they said they would remember Pinoy for pushing forward democracy, good governance, and the dignity of the human person. Catholic Bishops Conference of the Philippines also said it is grateful for the mutual respect between the church and state during his time. The group also recognized Aquino's role during the canonization of Blessed Pedro Colungsod in 2012 and Pope Francis's visit to the Philippines in 2015. A sad day for the Philippines following the death of former President Benigno Simeon Cuanco Aquino III. The former chief executive died Thursday morning at the age of 61. Last night, President Rodrigo Duterte signed a proclamation declaring 10 days of national mourning over the former Philippine leader's death. From June 24 to July 3, the Philippine flag will be flown at half staff at all government buildings and installations.
It is with profound sadness that I learn of the passing of the former president, Benigno S. Aquino III, this morning. We thank the former president for his service to our country. I hope that my fellow Filipinos will be inspired by his legacy. I offer my heartfelt condolences to the Aquino family. Be assured of the government's assistance in this period of mourning. And above all, please accept the love and the prayers of a grateful nation. You know, as always, when I talk to the family, I had the chance to talk to the family of them. Yung namatay. I could hardly find the right words to say the condolences. So, but every time, sinasabi ko na, para naman ito sa lahat sa atin, Ecclesiastes 3. And the long and short of the message there is always a time for everything in this planet. So whatever it is, we will always have our appointed time.
The late president's sister, Chris Aquino, thanked President Duterte and the public for their sympathies.
Nagpapasalamat kami sa lahat ng mga nagpapadala ng kanilang mga condolences, sa lahat ng mga nakikita namin, na mga nakikiramay sa amin, sa lahat ng mga mayor, sa lahat ng mga gobernador, sa lahat ng mga establishmento na on their own nag-decide na i-half-staff ang mga bandila ng Pilipinas. Thank you dun sa honor guard na pinapadala ngayon. Pero nire-respeto po namin na nandito pa rin tayo sa gitna ng isang pandemya. And we would have wanted so much more for our brother. Maraming salamat sa Malacañang dahil nag-reach out sila. Maraming salamat kay Presidente Duterte dun sa kanyang nararamdaman namin na sinseridad.
The Aquino family devastated over the loss of former President Aquino. But while Noynoy's passing has left them hurting, his sisters believe he had accomplished his mission.
It is with profound grief that on behalf of our family, I am confirming that our brother, Benigno Noynoy S. Aquino III, died peacefully in his sleep. His death certificate pronounced his death at 6:30 a.m. due to renal disease secondary to diabetes. No words can express how broken our hearts are and how long it will take for us to accept the reality that he is gone. Mission accomplished, Kanoy. Be happy now with Dad and Mom. We love you and we are so blessed to have had the privilege to have had you as our brother. We will miss you forever, Noy.